स्टार्ट रिकॉर्डिंग फर्स्ट हम आगे आने थे मिरंदा से हैं जनन जनन सोलह के जैसे और मिलता हम ये ना तस्मय श्री गुरु वे नम श्री चैतन्य मन विषम सभी तम ये नम तले स्वयं रूपा कदम यम ददति स्वपदंतिकम वंदे हम श्री गुरु श्री युता पद कमलम श्री गुरु वैष्णव श्री रूपम सग्रजतम सगुण रघुनाथन्वितं तं सचिवं चरितं सरितं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य श्री राधा कृष्ण परं सगन ललिता श्री विशाखमितं से हे कृष्ण करुण सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिकाकांत राधा कंच नमस्ते तप्त कंचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिय वंच कल्पतरुभ्यः कृपासिन्धुभ्यः वच अतिदनं भवानीभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभुनित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर सरस्वती गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सो टुडे वी विल रीड फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भगवद् गीता चैप्टर 1 टेक्स्ट नंबर 2 ओ सर So usually we will read like this and then you can repeat actually. Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya uva. What uva?
Uvacha. This
you. Vacha.
Yeah. This is
Vacha.
Yeah, and we just read now. This is mean explaining that Sanjaya is speaking. So you can just repeat now, and this is the practice of how you read, how read the Sanskrit as well. Although it's not in Devanagari script, but this is very important. Because in Bhagavad Gita, mostly using Anustup Chanda. Anustup Chanda, this is of Anustup Chanda. And Chanda is like different type of how the composition of the sloka. Like in Khmer also we have, you know, in Khmer we have different type of like Khmnap. They have certain length. Also this is this is called Anustup Chanda. Or we usually say sloka. So if we count here, there is actually the pattern. The syllable, you know, okay. Syllable, siang, siang.
Yeah.
So this is actually, we can count. So this one is one. You can count one. Dri. This is one siang. Because the R with dot below, it is not a consonant, but it is actually vowel.
Okay.
This is dri.
Dri.
Yeah, you can count dri. One. Yeah, dri.
Dri.
Sta. Okay, dri stwa.
Sta.
Stwa. This one is, yeah, you can count. Stwa. It's two, right?
Two.
Two, and then yeah. Two. You count three. Now three, right? Dri stwa.
Yeah.
Two.
Dri stwa.
Two. Already three now, right? So and then pa.
Yes.
Pa. Is four. And then da is five, and then wa is six.
Six.
Ni seven, and kam is eight. So actually, if we count, actually, not all of the verses of Bhagavad Gita having this pattern, but mostly using this. The short one is using this one. So it will be eight. Eight syllables or prambe siang, one line like this. This is called pada, so we should know. This is usually opening. Not every sloka have this. Usually, if somebody said starting set, they will put, for example, Sri Bhagavan Vacha, I mean Lord Krishna said, and here Sanjaya Vacha is like that. So without counting this, so there is a pattern. This is the way of a Vedic matter. There is a matter or the size or how to compose the slokas. So these slokas is consists of eight syllable. Each pada. This is one pada. We call pada. Yeah.
What pada mean?
Pada means a quarter of the slokas. Pihak selauk mui yang cie pun bontol yang hauta pada. It is one time when we you say like one line at a time. For example, we say Dristva tu pandavanikam. This is like one line. Like that.
Okay.
So in Sanskrit this is called one pada. And then this second pada. And this is third pada. And this is fourth pada. So
and the last?
Yeah, this is also if we count everything here, it was eight, right? We already counted eight.
Yeah.
Eight. So this will be also eight. Let's try. View.
Okay.
Dhang is you can count. I will show it, and you can count. View.
View.
Dha.
Dha.
Madhu.
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 Yeah. Okay.
Madhu. This one is very difficult to pronounce, but actually.
Madhu.
Rio. Rio.
Madhu. Rio.
Dha.
Dha.
Na.
Na.
Sta.
Sta.
Da.
Da.
How much? Did you count, right? You count. Eight also should be eight.
By bon pem pemoy pem by yes.
Yeah, so eight. It's actually like that. And so Bhagavad Gita is not composed like without any regulation. There is a regulation. So that's why it's called Gita. Mm-hmm. Gita means song. Right? Gita means song.
Okay.
So this is like the song of is composed in the poems, you know. And the poems in Vedic texts is always following this kind of. There is different type of chandas. This is following anustup or sloka. So in that way, we will be easy. It will be easy for us to pronounce or read. Okay, so we can try to read again. So in the next time, we can also discuss if you still don't not. So the simple way is we just read like that. Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu pandavan.
Nikam. Vyudhang Duryodhanastada.
Vyodam Duryodhanas Tada.
And actually this one, if you see M with the dot up, it is like we call what to say a nasal sound. This is a nasal sound and this is like similar to because you speak French, right? It's like in French there is a nasal sound, you know, like that. Yudhang.
I don't understand.
This one.
Can
if you
say again?
If you see this, there is M with dot up.
On the top, yeah.
Yeah, on the top. This is like like that. Yudhang. Like yeah, in French, there's a lot of nasal sound, right? Like that. Yudhang Duryodhang. We can say like that. Yudhang Duryodhanas. This is called Vishnu Chakram. Vishnu Chakram, or in the grammar is called as I forgot the name, but in the Harinamamrita Vyakarana it is called Vishnu Chakram. Yeah. There is dot up like that. So we can say we can read as Vyudhang. Vyudhang. Vyudhang Duryodhanastada.
Vyudhang.
Yeah,
you
this is like.
Can...
Yeah, but
but
if
here
you.
I don't find. Wait.
Yeah, that's why.
You okay?
Yeah,
your
this.
tongue.
Your tongue, Duryodhana stada.
Duryodhana
stada.
Chada. Duryodhana stada.
Okay.
Oh, very difficult to read.
No, now we just practice. This is okay. At first time might be like that, but it's not that difficult actually. So you just try to read now. Just try to read. Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya
uvacha. Yeah.
Sanjaya uvacha.
Drishtva tu pandava nikam.
Drishtva tu pandava pandava nikam.
Vyudham Duryodhanastada.
Vyudham Duryodhanastada. Tada.
Acharyam Upasangamya.
Acharyam Upasangamya. Gamya.
Gamya. Yeah, that's correct. And here, between M and U, this one we can combine. Because in Sanskrit, even between the words, we call sandhi. There is no stop actually. Acharyam upasangamya, acharyam upasangamya. We can say.
Acharyam
upasangamya, like that. Between this, we don't need to put any space. Just
okay.
Acharyam upasangamya. You can try again.
Okay. Acharyam upasangamya.
Raja vachanama bravit.
Raja. Again.
Wow.
Can you repeat?
This one is wa.
Raja.
If you see, this one is wa. Raja vachanama bravit.
Raja va
Wacha cha. This one is cha.
Wacha nam.
Nam abravit. Wacha nam abravit. This one without space. We can put just that.
Okay. Raja vacham.
Wacha nam abravit.
Nam abravit.
Yeah. Okay. We practice bravit. Several times. You practice several times because it is the first time for you to pronounce. It's okay. So, Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya uvacha.
Yeah. Drishtva tu pandava nikam.
Drishtva tu pandava nikam.
Yeah. And this one here, like in Khmer script, there is in Khmer sound, there is to do tu no to no, like that. This one is like the first one, like, you know, our teeth here is like ta. This one is not really like te sound, but it's like little bit, you know, it's like strong. I don't know what is. I forget this term. Yeah, drishtva. That's why if you hear usually Indians they say something, usually using this sound, you too something like that. For example, if you hear Indian accent, usually they say like that. You too, like that.
You too.
Ta, like not te. Te is like soft. This one is like
okay,
like that. So we can say drishtva tu panda. This one D with dot down here is also like that. Da pandava nikam.
Da. Da.
Yeah. And if we see
drishtva.
If we say, if you see this A with the like line up or I with it with a line up over there, it's mean like we pronounce longer than two times. This one and this one is having a different length. This one is, let's say, one unit, and this one is should be two unit with A. So sometimes when there is two word having the same A and then combined together become long.
Okay.
That is we call dirgha, or in Hari Nama Mrita Vyakarana we call as what is it? Vamana and Trivikrama. This is called Trivikrama, mean long. So okay, we now this is only information about technical how we read things.
Okay.
And this one is like, you know, there's koko 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 ngo, like that is ang. This one is upasang, like n but it's like ngo, like that. Yeah, upasang gamya.
Upasang gamya. Sang gamya.
You know, koko koko ngo. Yeah, like ngo. Like
ngo. No. Okay. N.
Yeah. It's like that. It's like that. So okay, we try several times to pronounce this because it is the first time for you to try to pronounce. It is very important because, you know, this is Gita. We call Gita. Gita means song. So it's like poems. So we can start again. We try several times, and next time we just read once as well. Shan, this one nya nyo. If in Khmer it's like cho
nya.
Nyo, yeah. San. I like that. So yeah. Sanjaya uwaca.
Sanjaya uwaca.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Yudham duryodhanastada.
Yudham
duryodhanastada.
Duryodhanastada.
Acharyamu pasangamya.
Acharya.
Yeah. We don't
need Acharya.
Yeah. Without E here, without I. Acharya. Ria.
Okay. Acharya.
Acharyamu pasangamya.
Acharyamu pasangga.
Gamya. So that's why we call it semi-vowel. This one is called semi-vowel. It is, if you see why, it is actually semi-vowel. It's not consonant, it's not vowel, but it is in between. Semi-vowel, you know. Semi-vowel. So people usually will put Y is like between I and A. So many people usually will read Ria. Yeah. Yeah. But actually we just put it short. Acharya without Acharya, like that. So Acharyam upasangamya.
Acharyam upasangamya.
Raja vachanama bravit.
Raja vachanama bravit.
Okay, that's good. We will read several times. Anyhow, today's verse is not having long purport as well. So I put this for the technicality of reading because this is also quite important. Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya uvacha.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Dyutam duryodhanastada.
Jutam Duryo Tanastada.
Okay, good. Acharya Mupasangamya.
Acharyam Jyamo Padang Acharyamu Padanggamya.
Upasanggamya.
Upasanggamya.
Is it not clear enough? Maybe I need to make it bigger. Yes, wait.
Yes.
Okay, wait. This is 90%. I will put more. Yeah. Is it clear now?
Yeah.
Clear. Okay, bigger text. It's okay, it's easier. Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya uvacha.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Vyudham duryodhanastada.
Vyudham duryodhanastada. Danastada.
Acharyamu pasangamya.
Acharyamu padang
upasangamya.
Upasangamya.
Raja. Yeah, you can compare here. A here and A here is different. This one is a little bit long, two times long. Raja vachanam abravit.
Raja vachanam nama. Raja vachanam abravit.
Okay, so now we just read again and again. Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya uvacha.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Vyudham duryodhanastada.
Vyudham duryodhanastada.
Acharyamupasangamya.
Acharyamupadang.
Upasang.
Upasang gamya.
Raja vachanam abravi.
Raja vachanam abravi.
Okay. Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya uvacha.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu padava. Padang vani, okay. Padavanikam.
Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu padavanikam. Pandavanikam.
Vyudham duryodhanastada.
Vyodam Duryodhanastada.
Acharyamupasangamya.
Upasangamya.
Raja vachanam abravit.
Raja vachanam abravit.
Sanjaya uvacha.
Sanjaya uvacha.
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 Drishtva tu pandavanikam.
Drishtva tu padavanikam.
Don't lose this.
Pandavanikam.
Vyudham duryodhanastada.
Vyudham duryodhanastada.
Acharyamupasangamya.
Acharyamupasangamya.
Raja Vaca Nama Bravi.
Raja Vaca Nama Bravi.
Sanjaya Uvaca.
Sanjaya Uvaca. Uvaca.
Drishtva Tu Pandavanikam.
Drishta Tu Pandavanikam.
Vyudham Duryodhanastatha.
Yodam Duryodhanastada.
Acharyamupasangamya.
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 Ya.
Ya.
Raja Vaca Nama Bravit.
Raja Raja Vasana Mo Bravi.
Vachana Ma Bravi.
Raja, again. Can you
Raja Vachana Ma Bravi.
Raja Vachana Mo Nama Bravi.
Yeah. So you want to try by yourself first? No? Try.
Okay. Once. Sanjaya, oh, I don't know how to, you know, the
melody. Sanjaya Uvaca. It's like actually just Sanjaya Uvaca. Like that.
Sanjaya Uvaca, Uvaca.
Yes.
Drishtva, Drishtva Tu Pandava Nikam.
Drishtva Tu Pandava Nikam. Yeah.
Drishtva Tu Pandavanikam.
Yeah, you can continue.
Vyodam Duryodhanastada.
Vyodam Duryodhanastada. Yeah, usually like that. If one read one line and everybody else will repeat also. If you read, then I will repeat. Then you can continue to the next one like that.
Okay.
Yeah. Please.
Acharyam upasangamya.
Acharyam upasangamya.
Vacha. Vaca Nama Bravit.
Okay. Once more.
Raja Vaca Nama Bravit.
Okay, that's okay. Enough for today for this. So we'll see. Sanjaya Vaca. So you might questioning here, why here there is Sanjayaha, here no H, yeah? You might question about this. Why it is like this? Because it is using the Sandhi. Sandhi mean the junction between either vowel or the consonant. If they join together, sometimes there is change, little bit change. For example, like, you know, in Khmer song also sometimes they put like that. For example, the change of the sound also. For example, usually I heard in the Khmer song, usually they use this sound. Sometimes they put that, but actually the word is not using that. It's not using that one. So it is similar like that. Not exactly the same, but this is like that. So you see here, Sanjayaha Uvaca.
Yeah.
Here is with A, Sanjayaha. Here without. Because why? Why? This one is in the form of song or poems. So we need to put according to Sandhi rules. Here is without. without the Sandhi rules. Why? Because it is like sentence, like in the sentence. Oh, wait. Trying. I put this one.
Drishtva.
Like Krishna, right? You see
Krishna,
the right?
Krishna.
Ri. Okay, sorry. This one going to
the internet connection.
Wait.
Pandava.
Don't scare with this, actually. It is not that difficult, actually. When we practice day by day, and we'll be okay.
Yeah.
And how to practice is, actually, before we read, we always ask everybody to repeat. That is why cannot. It's not internet connection, but I think the browser is having problem.
If you have the book, I can read because now okay. I have the book with me.
Yeah. Okay. I will. Okay. So you just see in the book.
Yeah.
I will take. Where's the book? Yeah. Okay.
Sanjaya Uvaca Uvaca.
Yeah. If you see C A, that is not K. Not as English. Oh, it's now coming. This one.
Okay.
So, Sanjaya Wacha, you can repeat.
Sanjaya Uvaca.
Sanjaya said. You can read the translation. Sanjaya said. You can repeat after me. Yeah.
Sanjaya said.
Drishtva. After seeing. To.
But.
Pandava anikam. The soldiers of the Pandavas.
Vyudham.
Arrange.
Here, can I ask?
Yes.
With M here with.
Yeah.
If it the sound is M or N.
M.
Okay.
M.
Okay. Vyudham.
Yeah. Vyudham. Arrange in a military phalanx.
Arrange in the military
phalanx.
Okay.
Phalanx. Military phalanx is like, you know, there is a infantry, there is a, how do you say, different type of a military. This is the system. Duryodhanaha. King Duryodhana.
Tada.
At that time.
Acharyam.
The teacher.
Acharyam.
Yeah, acharya is teacher. Actually, acharya means teacher. Yeah. Upasangamya.
Can you repeat?
Upasangamya.
Upasangamya.
Approaching.
Approaching.
And then Raja.
Raja.
The king.
The king.
Like Khmer word. Richie, Priharichie.
Okay. Yeah. Yes.
Wajanam.
Wajanam.
Words.
Wajanam. Words.
Like, you know, Wajanya Prai. Yeah, I used to read this. It means that.
Oh, Wajanam. Word, Nukrong, Wajana.
Wacha, yeah, Wajana is word. Wacha.
Okay. Okay.
Nice. Abravit.
Abravit.
Spoke.
Spoke.
The translation and purport by His Divine Grace, Abhay Charanarayan Bhagavadanta Srila Prabhupada Kijaya. Translation. Sanjaya said, O king, after looking over the army arranged in military formations by the sons of Pandu, King Duryodhana went to his teacher and spoke the following words. You can repeat after me. Sanjaya said,
Sanjaya said,
O king,
O king,
after looking over the army,
after looking over the army,
arranged in a military formation,
arranged in the military formation,
by the sons of Pandu,
by the sons of Pandu,
King Duryodhana, went to his teacher and spoke the following words. Okay, I will read this. Dhritarashtra was blind from birth. Unfortunately, he was also bereft of spiritual vision. He knew very well that his sons were equally blind in the matter of religion, and he was sure that they could never reach an understanding with the Pandavas, who were all pious since birth. Still, he was doubtful about the influence of the place of pilgrimage, and Sanjaya could understand his motive in asking about the situations on the battlefield. Sanjaya wanted, therefore, to encourage the despondent king and thus assure him that his sons were not going to make any sort of compromise under the influence of the holy place. Sanjaya therefore informed the king that his son Duryodhana, after seeing the military force of the Pandavas, at once went to the commander-in-chief, Dronacharya, to inform him of the real position. Although Duryodhana is mentioned as the king, he still had to go to the commander on account of the seriousness of the situation. He was therefore quite fit to be a politician, but Duryodhana's diplomatic veneer could not disguise the fear he felt when he saw the military arrangement of the Pandavas. So Hare Krishna, so he is still here describing about the situation before Lord Krishna speaking actually. Before Lord Krishna speaking, actually, in chapter 1, this few verses actually describing. That's why it is. We also need to understand the context. Yeah. So, first time was inquiry in the text 1, inquiry from Dhritarashtra about people. I mean, this. He mentioned that my son and the son of Pandu gathering in the place of pilgrimage, Kurukshetra, with the desire of to fight. What did they do? So he was asking like that. And then now Sanjaya here is replying to the king. Because the king is, Dhritarashtra is blind. Dhritarashtra is actually blind. And Sanjaya is like secretary for him. He is not in the battlefield. Both of them are not in the battlefield. But Sanjaya is given a vision. He can see from far away by the mercy, the blessing of Vyasadeva. By the blessing of Srila Vyasadeva. that he can see whatever happening in the battlefield. So Dhritarashtra is asking to Sanjaya, his secretary. So Sanjaya here is replying to Dhritarashtra from the previous. If you see back, can you see back the text number one?
Yes, I will go back. Yeah.
Just a little.
Yeah, bit. I can see.
Yeah. You say, Dhritarashtra said, "Oh Sanjaya, after my sons and the son of Pandu assembled in the place of pilgrimage at Kurukshetra, desiring to fight, what did they do?" So this is the reply, the reply to his question. So Dhritarashtra, Dhritarashtra is a blind king. So here in the Purpasula Prabhupada mentioned that Dhritarashtra was blind from birth. Yeah. So that's why he was not being appointed as a king. Because why? Because Kshatriya or the king, he should be able to do different type of duties, that he should be independent. Actually, the king is independent, but they get the consultation from the brahmanas, from the intelligent class of men. He taking advice from them. But beside that, he is like independent. So king will decide. For example, he should be very strong.
Okay.
To protect his citizen. For example, is in the society there is a thief or whatever. King should be very powerful so that he can actually punish the thief and punish the miscreant, like that. He should be very strong. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's not fit to be king. And if he is blind, then he cannot even know what is happening, right? So Dhritarashtra was not appointed to be the king that time. So if we going back to the setting the scene, we will know how it was there. So here is explained by Prabhupada. Dhritarashtra is blind, but also is not only blind, but he has no spiritual vision. He bereft of spiritual vision. Yeah. Actually, he know that what he is doing is not correct. Because the kingdom is belong to his brother, his younger brother. That time already died when he come to the forest. The Pandu is the brother of, if you see this Pandu, the name is the brother of Dhritarashtra. So he was a king, and then he was dying. When he go to the forest, and then in the tradition is that the son of the king will be the next king. So that time, okay, the son of Pandu, it is Panda, was still very small, and had to wait for some time so that they can rule, right? But yeah, that time he was entrusted as a king, as a temporary king. Dhritarashtra was appointed as a temporary king when Pandu going to the forest to take rest a little bit, because he was having a lot of things, and then he was a little bit tired and just taking rest for some time in the forest. So when in the forest... Yes?
Okay. Because here I see that I confuse which king is blind. His name
Dhritarashtra.
Duryodhana?
Duryodhana is his son. He's not blind physically, but he is. It's very bad person, let's say. It's very bad in the... It's not... Yeah, it's the son.
Actually, this Tara has 100 sons. So this is the eldest son.
Oh, the eldest son of Drista.
Yeah.
Drista.
So here oh. We can see from the purport here. Dhritarashtra was blind from birth. Unfortunately, he was also bereft of spiritual vision. So Dhritarashtra is not okay. only blind physically, but he is also bereft of spiritual vision. He knew very well that his sons were equally blind in the matter of religion. The son is not blind physically, but in the matter of religion, they very cruel and then, how to say, doing many bad things. And he was sure that they could never reach an understanding with the Pandavas. Will never compromise. Yeah. With the Pandavas is the son of Pandu, the real king actually. The son of the real king. So Pandu is the son of, the Pandavas is the son of Pandu. Duryodhana is the son of Dhritarashtra. So they actually cousin, brothers, you know.
Cousin.
Yeah. Who were all pious since birth. So Pandavas, they have very good deed. They very pious. And still he was doubtful about the influence of the place of pilgrimage. So actually the inquiry of Dhritarashtra is why he was asking like that. Because he is afraid. Why? The battle was on the holy place. And then because this is happening in the holy place, so he was afraid that what is going to happen, because he know that his son is bad person, but somehow he wanted him to be next king actually. And then the Pandavas, they are very pious, very good person, and he was actually afraid that the holy place will give influence to the result of the war, like that. And here Srila Prabhupada mentioned that he was doubtful about the influence of the place of pilgrimage. And Sanjaya understand his question actually. What is the motive behind that? Because in the text one he was asking, after my son and the son of Pandu together in the battle of Kurukshetra, we desire to fight, and then what did they do? It is like a rhetoric question. And behind that, actually, he has motive to ask this. And then Sanjaya wanted, therefore, to encourage the despondent king and thus assure him that his son were not going to make any sort of compromise under influence of the holy place. Yeah. Sanjaya therefore informed king that his son Duryodhana, after seeing the military force of the Pandavas, advanced when the commander-in-chief, Dronacharya. Dronacharya is a commander-in-chief, you know, like the army, and there is the leader of the army. There is his commander-in-chief.
Okay.
How do you call in Khmer? Senapati, no? Not senapati.
Yeah, senapati. I think.
Yeah.
Normally, we don't really use this word much now.
Yeah.
But if we do like formal writing, we will use that word, senapati. Yeah.
Sena mean the army. Pati mean the controller or the one who is taking care or who is the leader, let's say. Pati is like bedai also. That's also. Mm. And then usually the wife call his call her husband as pati, bedai.
Okay.
So like that. So senapati or Dronacharya was a senapati, commander in chief at that time. So inform him the real position. Although Duryodhana is mentioned as the king, he still had to go to the commander on account of seriousness of the situation. Actually, Duryodhana is not king that time. He was just a son of Dhritarashtra, and is not king yet that time. It's like, you know,
okay.
how we call prince. This is we call prince.
Can but, I mean here? I want to clarify. So yes. Pandava.
Yes.
Pandava is like the name for the five children.
Of, five brothers.
Five brothers.
Five children.
How about the
Duryodhana is the eldest son of Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra have 100 sons.
So that 100 son, how do we call that 100 son as a whole?
Kaurava.
Okay, I see. Kaurava. So this is the name, one of the name from Kaurava.
Yeah, this is the eldest son.
Okay, I see. Kunchubong.
Yeah, Kunchubong. Yeah, like that. So Duryodhana is the eldest son of Dhritarashtra. So the son of Pandu, he called Pandavas. There are five.
Okay. Five yeah. Brothers. And Arjuna is one of them.
One of them. Yeah. It's,
okay, I see.
It's very
good. Just want to clean.
Yeah. So here mentioned that although Duryodhana here in the text we see. Raja Vachanam Abravit. Here is referred to Duryodhana. Yeah. He was not the king yet at that time. He was like a prince actually. Only a prince. But why here is called, he is referred to, Raja here is referred to Duryodhana. Why he is called Raja? It's mentioned actually. Why he is called like that? Because he is very good in politics. Diplomatic. So, Raja sometimes mean the kings, or sometimes also means that people who is very very expert in diplomatic also sometimes is called Raja. Rajaniti, you know, Rajaniti is a science of politics. So, of course, Duryodhana is very very good at politics, although he is a bad person, but he is very. Very good in politics, diplomatics, and different. He's very expert actually, but somehow he's not religious people. He's very very bad. So here the word Raja here mentioning that Duryodhana is one who is very expert in the science of politics or diplomatic. Yeah, but. Here is mentioned that it is not mentioned that Duryodhana said, but actually Duryodhana will speak on the next verse. He will speak. We will read tomorrow. He will speak. Then actually here is mentioned by Srila Prabhupada that Duryodhana was actually afraid actually. And he could not hide his fear. Actually, by asking this, you know, usually king is independent, and he done it. He was really really good. Actually, he done it to ask again to the commander in chief. Here, he's asking. It's mentioned that when he see the military. On the other side, he is fearing, he is afraid of that. Yeah. Okay, for today, I think will be enough for this. If you have any question before we stop, and we'll continue tomorrow. The next verse.
I'm thinking.
Yeah, so start from the next chapter. I will try to make an overview for the whole chapter first and then start like that. For now we just reading like flowing like that. That's an daily reading. And we can discuss. Okay, so if you have any more questions you can message me or you can message in the group as well so that
okay
maybe if you have question and you put in the group and then maybe Kirti also can know what is your question.
Yeah,
we can discuss more on the group. So thank you for today.
Okay.
training, for your enthusiasm.
Thank you so much.
And we will see you so in the chanting today.
Yeah.
Today is Monday. Monday, yeah. Today is Monday.
At what time?
At 8:00 Monday.
Okay. Yes. So yeah, see you.
See you again tonight, and for this part we'll see you tomorrow to continue.
Okay, yeah, see you tomorrow for
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jai Shri Prabhupada ki jai.